talk anymore. And we don't even know what we argue about. Don't even say I love you no more. Saying how we feel is no longer allowed.
Some people work things out and some just don't know how to change. Let's go wait till the water runs dry. We might watch our whole lives pass us by. Let's go wait till the water runs dry. Mistake of our lives. Don't do them, baby.
Everybody knows that we're both torn apart.
Why do we hurt each other? Why do we push love away?
Let's go wait till the water runs dry.
No,
we might watch our whole lives pass us by.
We might let our whole
lives pass us by.
I now call the October 9, 2012 Town Hall Meeting work session of the Riverton City Council to order at 7 p.m. Would Councilman Christensen please lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Would the city clerk please conduct the roll call?
Yes, Your Honor. Councilwoman Mary Ellen Christensen.
Present.
Councilman Todd Smith.
Here.
Councilman John Lars Baker.
Here.
Councilman Rich Gard.
Here.
Councilman Eric Heiser.
Here.
Mayor Ron Wartness.
I am present. The chair would entertain a motion to excuse Councilmember Mahoney from tonight's meeting.
Move to excuse Councilwoman Mahoney.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. I declare that we have a quorum this evening. The approval of the agenda. The chair would entertain a motion for the approval of the agenda.
I'd make a motion to approve the agenda, Mayor.
Second.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to approve the agenda as presented. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. At this time, the acting city administrator's report, Ms. Bolander, regarding yes. tonight's meeting.
Certainly, Your Honor.
Thank you.
The city administrator, before he left last Friday for his City Managers Association meeting, he wanted to make sure that I gave Bill a proper lead-in for this meeting.
Uh-huh.
After searching the internet trying to find streets and road jokes, I decided that they weren't appropriate for television, so I'm going to move on to the next thing. It's really a delight to see Bill today. He's just been acting like a little kid at Christmas time. He just loves all these interactions. He loves to talk, but I will tell you that I do have a pause button. So if you wish to have him pause, just look at me and I know what to do.
Okay.
To lead into this tonight, I just wanted to make sure that the council knew that this was a discussion facilitated totally by staff. This is an investment by the community, as you can see the members that are here that are going to be participating tonight. This does fulfill the third of your goals that you had a year and a half, almost 2 years ago. One was to start getting a 1% going. Yes. The second one was to establish neighborhoods for that, for street prioritization. So just to let you know that you are in line with your goals, and I'm sure that Bill is just going to give us a lot of entertainment tonight. We're so excited. So I'll defer the rest of the evening to Mr. Urbikite.
Thank you very much, Courtney. Mr. Urbikite,
I'm a little nervous knowing about this pause button now. Well, the chief just told me he's got a taser.
Yeah.
Actually, this is really a team effort, and so Courtney and Sandy have agreed to be helping me with this. And so our intent is that we had the neighborhood captains rank the roads and talk about the quality of the roads in their different neighborhoods. And then we as staff got that back, and Don Wilhelm, who works for me, kind of tried to compile that information into some kind of a semblance of what should be our priorities. And then Don and Paul and Greg working together kind of looked at that also. And what we've done is we've taken that information from the neighborhood captains and we made a list of 50 or 60 roads, which you got in your packet. And then we took and said, okay, we got to narrow this down a little bit. So we narrowed it down to 20 roads, and then the mayor pointed out that I forgot one of his favorite roads. So we've got 21 roads. And what our intention is to try to look at those 21 roads, and then with the help of the audience and you and the media, rank those roads. And so the first thing I want to do is, this is one of the very few city council meetings that everybody that came here gets a treat. And so if Courtney and Sandy will help me, everybody gets $1 and change.
Wow.
And we're going to pass out the change to everybody because everybody gets a second. By the way, they're in cute little Ziploc bags that have cars on them. So everybody will get $1 of change. And then as we go through and talk about the roads, everybody will get to vote on which roads they think are more important by putting their money where their mouth is. Mm. And they will vote for the road, and you can put part of your money on one road, part of it on another road, or you can put all of it on one road. And then as we go through this process, we'll then count and see how much money is in each road. And based on that, we'll have a very preliminary list of what we think the most important roads out of these 20 roads that we've identified are. So we are kind of winging this. And so what we're going to do is, as I go through each road, I'll ask everybody if they want to vote at that point in time. And I'll ask Sandy and Courtney to go around and collect the money, so in these buckets. And then what we've done is we've also looked at the roads and we've said, okay, whose ward is this in? And we'll bring the money and the map for that road to whichever council person that it corresponds to and ask them to count the money out and write it on the map so that we'll know at the end of the time. That way we'll be able to kind of compile the information as we go along. We assume that you can all count change. That seems to be a reasonable assumption. So I guess with that, we won't go into a lot of detail about any road. With 21 roads, if I spend more than 5 minutes on each road, we'll be here past 9 o'clock. So I've got to go along pretty quickly. So we'll try to talk about each road, and then we'll give everybody an opportunity to put some money in the hat and vote on that road, and then we'll go on to the next road. So Courtney and Sandy are going to be up wandering around a lot, and the cups that you've got there in front of you are for where you put your loose change when you're done. Okay, so hopefully we'll gather it all up. And I was supposed to make this clear. This is my loose change that I gathered off my dresser this morning. It's not the city's money. And when we're done, you guys, depending on which roads get voted more, get to decide whether it gets donated to breast cancer awareness or domestic violence. So there's a theme to my attire. I've got both colors covered in the process. So with that, unless you've got any questions, I'll get started. And I'll entertain questions about the roads, Tom. Oh, yeah. I have a few extra copies. Vanna. Vanna will pass them out. I've got Vanna and Vanna. So the first...
You're getting way into this too much, Bill.
I know. Yes, I am. Now, I do want to stress, we put these together. They are not in our priority or anybody else's priority. We just put them together and we put the maps together. So when you look at the first road, it's not that Paul Throckmorton and I are telling you that we think this is the most important road. We want to hear from you guys what you think is the most important road, but we just got it. We had to put them in a list somehow. So we didn't put any priority on them at all. The first road that we identified is North Broadway from Sunset up to the north end of Teeter Park. That really works when I'm shaking like that. You can't even see it. Obviously, right now, we're getting very close to, we hope to yet this week, pave Broadway from Logan Park on out. Oh, no, maybe not. We did run into a little hitch in the plan down there, but up there. But anybody that drives that stretch of road knows that North Broadway's in pretty rough shape from Sunset up to Logan Park. And so that was the first one that we put on the list of roads to be looking at. So with Sandy out wandering around, if anybody wants to vote for North Broadway, you can put your money in the bucket now. Or I think what we're going to do is after we get through all the roads, I think what you're going to want to do is wait until we're done with all the roads. And then you'll have to just figure out which councilman has this map and go give them the money. So Todd gets North Broadway. Okay. Then the next road that we've got identified, let's see if this works.
One question on Broadway.
Yes, sir.
The new section of Broadway is not much wider than the existing section that you're going to talk about widening.
Actually, we're not even going to talk about widening because there's two schools of thought. I'll just address that real quick. We just put widening on there and you look at that and you go, well, it's pretty narrow right now. The new section actually is 42 feet wide from back of curb to back of curb, which is what we identify in our code as a collector street. The existing street's 37 feet from back of curb to back of curb. Councilman Baker pointed out one time that, yeah, you want to have wide roads, but when you have wide roads, people drive faster. Narrow roads actually are traffic calming. When you come in on Riverview, you're going 50 miles an hour, you get to Majors and you slow down because the road gets narrower. So we're not making that recommendation. We're not making that suggestion. We'll want the citizens' input on that. The mayor and council will be the ones that decide that eventually. But widening roads, I'm not saying we're going to do that or not right at this point. Okay, so the next road is South Fourthwest from Adams to Monroe, which is barely a goat track at this point in time. And we look at that as being a potential truck route sometime in the future. And Councilman Gard gets that one. And Eric, you're going to get a lot because Diana didn't show up. Okay, the next street that we're identifying is Sunset from Forest to Aspen School. I think you all know where that is. Obviously, that street and that whole neighborhood gets mentioned a lot. Has got some issues, but because of the school district, it's getting increasingly heavy traffic, and it needs some work. So that one would be Eric's. The next street is Sunset from North 8th West to Broadway. And one of the things about Sunset that we identified a long time ago is that there's a lot of undersized and deteriorating water lines in there, but we fixed those. So that's kind of ready for some work now, and Mary Ellen gets sunset. Oddly enough, we didn't plan it this way, but the streets actually shake out to be pretty evenly distributed amongst the councilmen. We didn't want to have any favorites one way or the other. Monroe, from Peak to Broadway. Okay, this is down on the south side of town. I think you're familiar with it, the public workshop being out there on the west end of it. We built that from the railroad right-of-way to Peak back in the early 90s. And that was a swamp. It took a lot of money. A lot of it will just need overlaid. But the utilities are all done. And that one is in Ward 3. I'll give that to Councilman Baker. And then the next street that we've got, I've got to keep remembering to do this. Courtney, maybe you could help me and do the computer. Thank you. Pershing, Federal to the East End. And, you know, that's got some alignment issues, some drainage issues. It needs a lot of work. And Councilman Heiser gets to do Councilwoman Mahoney's work on that one. Okay, Courtney, next one. Page down. The next one is East Park from Broadway to Federal down, I call that the Church District, just a coincidence. But pretty important collector street. That being in the middle of the town gets Mary Ellen, Ward 2. Okay. Smith Road. Now, the mayor and I had an interesting conversation on this one. It's out on the east side of town, big industrial road, concrete, it's falling apart. Gets a lot of heavy traffic. Unfortunately, I think we could blow our whole roads budget even with the optional 1 cent on that street section. But it is bad, so it's on the list. And that's in Ward 1, so Councilman Heiser gets that. And then the next street, one that's near and dear to my heart, I drive on it frequently, is Adams from South Fourth West, which is by the old city shop, all the way to Federal. That street will require utility work. It's got a 4-inch cast iron pipe water line under it and irrigation ditches on both sides that all have to be fixed or rerouted or something done differently. Mary Ellen, Todd, who's got the most so far? Todd. Very busy street, though. It collects a lot of traffic for us. Okay. Next one. North 4th West and North 5th West. For lack of better description, this is up at Rendezvous School and the school district facilities by Tonkin Field. A lot of bus traffic, a lot of pedestrian traffic. Particularly on 4th Street, the school district actually came in and did a lot of work on the sidewalk and curb and gutter on the west side of the street, but the east side of the street, the curb and gutter is gone. It's turned to gravel. And so this one is Rich or Lars? Rich. Rich raised his hand. And then the next street is West Park. From North 8th West to North 5th West, this is one block south of Jackson School. Narrow street, doesn't even have curb and gutter and sidewalk on one side, needs a lot of work. I've got Mayor Rich or Lars on that one. We'll give that one to the mayor.
It's about time he got one.
Yeah, I know.
Wait, I thought I was going to get out of this.
You know, there's a limit how far I can push this. But the next street is North 1st from Sunset to Lincoln. So in front of Ashgrove School, going up to Sunset, this would be in Ward 2. Whose turn? Also another, you'll notice that there may be, from our standpoint, when we looked at these and talked about priorities, we look at this traffic and the schools, and there's maybe a little emphasis on trying to make the streets safer around the schools. Next one is Riverview from Spire to Major. We did Riverview out to Spire as part of an urban systems project a number of years ago, and then we built Majors, and boy, we got a mess in between there. And that's Lars. And then the next one being North 16th East, from Park to Redwood. Eric knows where that is. Another street that has increasingly more traffic because of the construction of the school out on that part of town. And one that, you know, we anticipate when North Federal gets worked on, that there'll be a lot of people trying to find ways around Federal, and that street will probably be one that will be used a lot. North 8th West, from West Park to West Main. That's a mayor one. By the number 2 Fire Hall. We did North 8th West from Park on out to Sunset a few years back, but that last section, and anybody that drives by it, it's got that messed up storm drain, and the curb and gutter shot, the sidewalk shot, and the street's a mess, and it's incredibly rough and hard to drive on. Okay, the next one is North 9th West, from West Park to West Main. And which one of you three guys? That's,
I got two.
That's, he says give it to Lars. That's one block over. Same thing, it was built a long time ago. We've got some drainage issues there. Our crews have been working on the valley pen. I think we're probably done with that. But because of the drainage issues, the asphalt's pretty shot on that street. Here's one that I know somebody in the audience will be interested in. I think. You still own property on Gannett Drive, Debbie? Gannett Drive. It's a wreck. That one has some serious underdrain problems that we'll have to work on because the groundwater is so shallow there, and that's why the street's falling apart. Plus, we had a water main blow up in the middle of it. And we're still working on trying to repair all the damage from that. But its pavement structure is gone. Actually, Mayor Tippett's, I saw him come in. You're familiar with that street, I believe, Mayor Tippett's. It's like where you live. Okay, the next one is North 2nd West from Sunset to Pershing. That would be over by Sunset Park. And really, it's just old. It's just old pavement. It's worn out. It didn't help that at one point in time we used to flood the parking lot at Sunset Park for an ice skating rink, and it broke one winter and turned the whole thing into a big mess, ice skating rink, and it tore up the asphalt pretty bad. The next one is East Forest and Maple in the Woodridge Estates subdivision, and anybody that's been over there and looked at that pavement, it is, the aggregate is so exposed because it's aged so badly that it looks like a gravel road already because there's no bituminous material left in there holding the aggregate together. And the next one is same neighborhood, just going the other direction. Pinecrest from Forest to Beach. Eric gets that one also. And the last one is Pure Gas Road from Sunset to Webwood. And I'm going to give that one to the mayor since he asked me to add that one on. And anybody that's been down Pure Gas Road, you know, that's an old county road that was put in 100 years ago, literally. And part of the issue with that was that there was an open irrigation ditch along the railroad right away for years, and it leaked badly. And so the road fell apart. Excuse me. The irrigation district came in and piped the ditch, kind of solved the water problem. But the pavement's still shot, so that one definitely needs some work. So that's the 21 roads, and this is going a lot quicker than I thought, because I thought we were going to stop and vote for every one of them. But with that, you know, you've all got your dollars worth of change, and you know by ward which one they're at. So we'll just take a few minutes. I can answer questions in the interim, but and if you want to, like, put all your money on one, they'll probably really appreciate that because they won't have to count it all out. They'll just go, that's a dollar. And I think there's a dollar in every bag. But if you'll all vote on which streets you think are the most important ones, then we'll total them up and we'll talk about what our priorities are. We'll give you a list of them from top to bottom. So let's take 5 minutes and 10 minutes and Vote on which streets you think are important. Yes, sir. Go ahead. Yeah, I mean, you all go vote while we're visiting with Mayor Tippett. Just ask. Just go up and ask them. They know. They can tell you. We took the gradings that we got from the neighborhood team captains.
Your gas road.
And we took the ones that were really bad roads, and we looked at those. But then we also...
That's your road, huh? I agree with that.
We had identified earlier in the year, the mayor and I and I don't know who all
Broadway
else got together and we said, who lives in this neighborhood that might help us? And we asked them to volunteer. And so then we sent them a letter and they came down and we talked about grading roads and we gave them survey sheets and they went out and looked at them and then they came back and gave us the information.
North 8th. Pure gas.
Well, I think all the influential people are like you that are sitting here because you took the time to come down and ask the question and got your dollar and get to vote.
Yeah, you can either divide it or all together.
Oh. Hang on to it. Hang on to it. No. When we get done voting, I wanted to ask about, did I forget any roads?
What is it?
So I'll get back to you. Which street?
All in. All in
Timber Lane?
So I need to put 33 cents on each of them.
Would you write Timber Lane down on that?
If you divide that last penny.
33 cents, okay. All right.
Yeah. Hello, oh, okay. Okay. I got it. Right here. Yes.
How are you? I'm good. How are you?
Adams. I have Adams from...
So okay. What were you looking for?
A long time ago, but it needs it again now.
This is 4th down by your folks' place?
No.
This is Fixture's old shop.
If we wouldn't have ran out of money on that project.
And this is the old high school.
It's not as bad as some.
Collector Street off, and this is the one that's...
Yeah, it's bad. Somebody brought up a good question. This fine lady over here brought up a good question. If there's a road on a street on the list or not on the list, or I haven't talked about it,
your guess is
that you want to add to it, tell Sandy and she'll write it on this board because we did want to make sure that we didn't miss any roads. So there might be some we forgot. Well, we missed or we overlooked.
Yeah, don't be so stingy. Come on. East what?
Give it to Ward 4. Give it to Todd or Mary Ellen.
Yes, we are. How's Kyle doing?
Back here.
Good.
Right.
How's Jonathan doing?
Which one? What road?
Which one are you looking for?
I think all right.
Riverview.
Okay, but that's Timber, Maple.
Fire to Maple.
Right.
Split it up between these three.
Oh. Okay.
Give it to Eric.
Park Street.
How are you?
Teeter Park. Oh, okay. This would not include that.
Moose, Elk, and Bighorn.
This is
okay.
That is
no, but we put Timber up. We're gonna vote for
pure gas.
We're gonna have.
These are the streets.
This is the street. West.
Yes, North 8th West. Park to West Main. Yep.
Put Timber's Lane slightly.
Good job. That's what we like to hear.
Broadway.
So the bench goes back.
Yeah,
North 8th to Broadway.
Right. All right, that's divided up.
It's $20 million.
Right. So, why don't we just add?
Oh,
this is nice. Yeah, and it's just really doesn't even have any curb or gutter.
Teeter Park.
This is the old fire hall.
It's going to get busy.
I think this is where the curb is. This side.
It's got a drain on
the side of the
village.
It's collapsed.
It is pretty crowded.
This is the administration.
Right, village drive. Yeah.
Main right here.
Uh huh.
That's right.
Yeah, you're right here.
Well, this is
section.
I would ask them. They haven't really discussed it.
Version here. You probably come up with version.
If it would have to.
That's just probably.
Country acres, you know, it's gonna go.
How's it going?
It's not impacting a lot of folks.
I know.
These are more, those are solid ones.
Save some for us down here, Carl. Don't give it all away. Oh, 3 cents, okay. Well, that's all right.
So I'm on this down here. This is all here.
Well, yeah, if we're not able to pass the 1%, why, these are projects that we're just not going to have the funding to do. We'll do as we can, you know, and out of our budget, but it'll be pretty tough.
Rich has got right
here. And this was
the yeah. We're out of money. You throw another dollar in there. And
here you go. This is
make change in Lars. Yeah. Make change in Lars Cup. Do you want to do that on Gannett? Okay. Super. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, pure gas seems to be a popular.
Good idea. We might be able to. It's a poor road.
It really is. Hello, Marlene. How are you?
So what do we do? Just tell
them? Yes. Pure gas seems to be the biggie. That a lot of people are.
Is this your thing?
Yes. Yeah. I'm not keeping track of it by the. I think we're just trying to get a.
I'm like at 386
right here.
Gannett's down here. Yeah.
So far.
Then I'll collect four of them.
I guess if I've counted it, I can.
This is just kind of a rough.
Yeah, this is our work.
But they're all, that's right. First Street is the one that I'm just embarrassed of every time I drive on. You know, and it didn't even make the list.
And I'm the captain for Village Drive. I just turned my stuff in.
Did you?
I was remiss in not getting it.
You're negligent in your duty, huh? Okay.
And marked on the back of the
picture. Good for you. No, if we're not able to get the 1% passed, why, it's a moot point anyway.
And this is by the high school. This is administration.
Yeah, there's a few for in here, but not enough.
But
I think 25 cents or so.
This is Hatville curb left here on the east side.
Yeah.
And then this is the goat trail. This is John Fixture's old shop.
Yeah.
Right.
Federal.
We're taking $100 bills.
Yeah, we'll take donations here.
Typical government, yeah.
I did on North Broadway.
I'm up to $20 here.
I didn't know I had that much to say.
You know, somebody's trying to pad the road. Stuff in the ballot box.
You can't take money out of your pocket.
Here's Riverview. Okay, and that's from Majors down the Spire Drive. And this is North Northwest from Park to Main Street.
Well, and it has the most money. So.
How about a 5 cent? Well, you just have to pick away.
Okay, we had.
This is fine. This is from Larson's Sunset all the way to Brooklyn. Yes.
The empty bag.
The empty bag.
Are we done?
I think so.
58. Okay. Has everybody voted? Are we pretty set there that we think we've all put our money in the pot? And judges, this is American, like American Idol. Judges, do you have your decision?
I do.
Courtney, could I ask you if they tell you what the dollar amounts are, is to write them down?
Sure.
So that we can see what the results are. So, should we just start at the top? North Broadway, Todd?
$3.86.
Okay. Set the bar high. South Northwest, Rich, is that yours?
10 cents. Big buyer there.
Well, I thought that was a more important street. Okay. East Sunset. That'd be Eric.
Forest Aspen, is that what you're
No, East Sunset from basically Federal to Aspen Park. Eric got a little swamped on this deal, so.
Zero.
I do want to just point out that there was at least two people that made a case for that whole neighborhood.
Now I'm going to bring that up when you.
Okay. All right. So then.
A lot of money there.
The next one is West Sunset. Marilyn or Todd's got that one.
West from the North 8th West Broadway?
Yes.
Okay, we have 98 cents.
98 cents.
Take that back, 98. $1.24, I didn't see.
$1.24, okay. That list isn't right. Better go back to the computer. Okay, so then West Monroe from Peak to Broadway. Is that you, Rich?
No, sir.
That's Lars.
West Monroe, Peak to Broadway, I have $1.58.
Okay. Pershing from Federal to the East End. That'd be Eric's.
$1.25.
No, Bill, that's wrong. Courtney, I'm sorry, that's wrong. It's just 58.
Well, that substantially got lower.
Were you taking your percentage out?
Well,
I'm taking my cut. Right.
This isn't supposed to be a money-making proposition for the council.
It's a money-making project for domestic violence.
Yeah, that's right. East Park from Broadway to Federal. That would be Mary Ellen or Todd.
That would be 18 cents.
Smith Road. 18 cents.
25 cents.
25 cents for Smith Road. Adams from South Northwest to Federal. That's Rich, I think.
Adams would be 60 cents.
Oh, I'm sorry, Todd. 60 cents. Okay. North 4th West and North 5th West. That's Rich.
$1.46.
$1.46.
That's a big winner on my table.
West Park from North 8th West to North 5th West.
That would be 46 cents.
Okay. North 1st from Sunset to Lincoln.
94 cents.
Okay. Riverview from Spire to Major. That's Lars.
85 cents.
With or without your cut.
North 16th East from Park to Redwood, Eric.
That's the one that I've got to change. Looking at, so I don't know how you want me to, if you want to add that to the list or.
Do you want to aggregate that with the whole neighborhood?
I want to aggregate it with fir, timber, and Woodridge.
Okay.
Okay.
So what's your total?
210.
210 for all of those. It'll got a little backroom politics going on now, I think. So. Okay.
Glad to hear fir got in.
North 8th West from West Park to West Main. Mayor, I think you got that one.
That was 41 cents.
Okay. North 9th West from West Park to West Main.
That's 43 cents.
Gannett Drive.
53 cents.
North 2nd West from Sunset to Pershing.
Zero.
Zip. Okay. Not as bad as I thought. Okay, so Eric, then East Forest and Maple are all aggregated in with Woodridge and all of those others. Okay. Pinecrest goes with them.
Sure.
Okay. And then Pure Gas Road.
$1.60.
$1.60.
Yeah, it was a high one in my area.
Okay. Now we've addressed Timberlane Woodridge was brought up as one that we'd missed, and so we've aggregated those all together and say that whole neighborhood is one.
I had an addition okay. as well. I had a split for chip seal, moose, elk, and bighorn at 33 cents apiece.
Would you write that down, Courtney? Good call. Animal kingdom.
Moose, elk, moose. And bighorn, 33 cents apiece.
That's what Paul calls it, the animal kingdom. You can hear them on the radio. They're talking to the garbage truck driver. Where are you at? I'm in the animal kingdom. Oh, okay. Well, same thing. I don't know how to handle this. Village Drive. Marlene brought up Village Drive, and it is needs an overlay. We chip sealed it quite a few years ago, but it probably does need an overlay. Has everybody spent all their money?
Too late. The money's all gone, Bill.
This is preliminary. But we'll make a note of that Village Drive was added. The alley behind Rocky Mountain Sports. And that's a legitimate concern. Because particularly when North Broadway is being built, you know there's going to be a lot of traffic on it. I just mentioned it. We don't have any money left. We're not going to vote on it. But it's something we'll probably need to think about in the short, near-term future before we get ready for the North Federal Project. There were a couple other comments that I wanted to share with you. We asked the police department to take a look at some roads. The chief was kind enough to ask a couple of officers on the day shift to look at some. And one of the things that they pointed out is that Cherokee, Cheyenne, and Navajo, and Blackfoot, and Apache, and Comanche, and Shoshone, and Sioux, and Arapaho, the A&T Mobile Home Park, are all in horrible conditions. I think the officer's quote is, these roads are horrible, nearly impassable when heavy rain or snow. Those were paved. We worked on the sewers out there, and we kind of took them back to gravel. They still need a lot of work. And one of the things that certainly is my intention, and Paul and I have talked about this going forward, is we've had a lot of good luck lately working with recycled asphalt on gravel roads. And so our intention is, as we build out roads, assuming the one cent passes and we build out roads, we're going to specify that all of that used asphalt has to be roto-milled up and recycled, and we will then go place it on all the gravel roads that the city has. And then once we get the gravel roads done, we'll do the alleys so that we reuse that instead of just wasting that material. And certainly that neighborhood is one that we'd want to bring up. The officer that filled this one out certainly agreed that Pure Gas was very bumpy and a wreck. And he also pointed out that Hurst Street is gravel, but could use some work. That goes from Adams to Monroe by the Detox Center. And that West Jefferson just ends and turns into gravel and then swings around and meets Madison, and we might want to look at that one. Not a very heavily trafficked road. Probably wouldn't be what I would call a high priority. And then he also pointed out Railroad Avenue from Monroe down to the river, which is absolutely a wreck, I agree. The problem with that one is it's not on a public right-of-way. That's not a road from the standpoint of it's ever was a dedicated right-of-way. There is a series of easements from all of the property owners to each other to drive on that, but there's not really a road right-of-way there. So that's something that we probably will have to talk to those property owners down there and have them, you know, talk about dedicating that as a public road and forming an improvement district and paving it and building it as an industrial road. It's in a light industrial area. And then we could take over maintenance of it. We have on occasion gone down and filled potholes there because it did just get completely impassable, but it's not really a city street or a road. One of Mike's other officers created a whole new ranking system, which I haven't quite figured out yet. But he actually went and looked at the roads based on every one of them, on what their condition was, and then also on what the traffic load was, and ranked them all. I just haven't had quite a bit of chance to digest that. But I really appreciate the police officers taking the time going out and looking at them. I think these guys are driving on them all the time. They probably have some input that would be good. The other thing that happened is that we got one letter back from one of the other neighborhood captains who felt that all of the roads in Logan Park were fine, despite what Lee says. And he said, oh, they look pretty good. Carl Anderson, who was one of our neighborhood team captains, looked at roads in his neighborhood, and he certainly agreed with Sunset, First Street. He thought North 2nd West was also important, which got zero money. But he also pointed out that Liberty and Independence, which are up behind the UPS, are in horrible condition, and he's correct. And they've got real drainage problems there, and that's something that as we go down the road, we'll need to look at that because they literally are falling apart. It was built on a swamp to start with, and those roads just aren't holding up even to just a very limited neighborhood traffic they get. But I wanted to share those with you, and really I'm just filling time so that then Courtney can tell us now what the rankings are. Oh, she was in trance. So I was hoping that Courtney would now tell us what the list of the roads are, what the highest to the lowest is.
Only time I've listened. Only time. So, of course, North Broadway. And then North 16th East. East to Sunset and Pershing, Redwood.
The whole.
Right. Then North 5th West, North 4th West. Then it looks like East Pershing, North Federal, North 12th East, and then East Sunset was the next one. And then you're getting down into the cents. Common sense.
So, no, just top five.
Right.
Broadway, 4th and 5th, 16th, Woodridge Estates area. It was 4th, I'm sorry.
4th was East Pershing.
East Pershing.
East Pershing. 5th was East Sunset.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
You have the results.
Thank you. Thank you, Bill. That was an interesting exercise. I don't think I've ever done anything quite like that before. Thank you for the donation. We appreciate it. So you probably want the money back if I had to guess.
No. Who had the leader? Who had the most money? Todd? I was very serious. This is lease change for my house. And all of the money, since Todd got the top, gets to decide whether it goes to domestic violence or breast cancer awareness. We're going to just donate all the money to one of those worthy causes, since it's October is those months. So, Todd, your choice.
My choice? Oh, boy. I guess we'll go with breast cancer awareness.
Yeah.
Hey, that's great. Thank you, Todd. I would just like to take a moment other than thanking Bill and the rest of the staff for putting this together, and hope we all had a good time, you know, discussing a very serious issue here. I think the most important thing to me, having worked on this for quite a while, when John Darrington, our city administrator, was here as an interim, why John is the one that really spearheaded this initially and made a lot of sense, and we've gotten to this point. But I think that the really important thing is that you as citizens know that we're dead serious, that we want your input into this process, that it's not just coming from us picking out what streets we think, but we want your input into it as well to make sure that you hold our feet to the fire. I know there are some folks out there that think, well, as soon as the politicians get their hand on money, why, then they'll spend it however they want to. And I can assure you that that's not the attitude of all of the FCAG representatives, nor the county commissioners, I believe. And so it's, you know, it's just important that you be here and be involved in the process. There's some signs outside regarding the 1% optional tax. If anybody wants to demonstrate their support publicly, why, we encourage that. Dave Meyer is here as the chairman of our PAC, and I really appreciate your help, Dave. And Kyle Leto is here as well, and so that's good. As Bill was talking about the police officers that are ranking the streets and whatnot, they have to drive on these streets, and if anyone has ever ridden with them, they drive pretty fast. And some of the chuckles that you hit does not do anything positive for the front end of a very expensive police car. The other thing, I've talked to the folks that drive the ambulance vehicles, and they try to drive quickly as possible, safely. And if you have someone in the back that has fallen and broken their hip or something, and they have to make it over some of our streets, it's a very, very painful operation. And so, you know, it's important for us to realize that it's not just, you know, making the street smooth and look nice. It really is a functional and a practical need that our community has. And so with those comments, I'd just turn it over to the council if anyone else would like to share any thoughts. So,
Your Honor, a question was asked of me just yesterday, and that question was once the 1 cent goes into effect, it never goes away. And I don't know if that was experience speaking or if that was not understanding the process. This tax will have to be voted for every 4 years. And so we will get another chance to either say that we do like it or we don't like it. And the voters will be listened to at the polls. And so it isn't a tax that has to stay. It is a tax that they have the opportunity to vote out in 4 years or back in. And I just wanted to make that publicly. I know it's been stated numerous times, but I was surprised that they didn't understand that fully. And so they will get another chance to vote on it, whether they like it or don't like it. Thank you, Your Honor.
That is correct. We won't have to go through the same process to get it back on the ballot. It will automatically go on to the ballot, but it will have to be voted on again by the public. And if the public votes it down at that time, then the next time, if we want to put it in place, it will have to go through the whole process again. And so it's kind of like that. Anyone else? Comments?
Your Honor.
Yes. Councilman Heiser.
I guess for me, and having been through a couple of these unsuccessfully, the most compelling argument I would make, you can call it either, I would say it's probably a neutral position, in that it's time that we as a city and as a county start looking at the ways that we can help ourselves. When you put your hand out for grants left and right, one of the first things that they do is ask how much your tax is. What are you doing to help yourself? And I know we talked about this a couple weeks ago and Councilman Gard brought it up. And it may sound like rhetoric, but it's true. If you're not going to tax yourself, then a lot of these granting agencies just really aren't interested in talking to you. So I think it's a good opportunity for us to look at what we're doing for the betterment of our community. And again, it's obviously asking for more money, but I think a lot of times this tax is viewed as what we call the fairest tax, because it's a sales tax. It's not a tax on just people who happen to own property or just people who happen to have some things that others don't. And the other bonus that we get is travelers passing through help us pay for it as well. So I would definitely agree with the sense that if there's a way to do it and a way to raise money to do the necessary, not necessarily the funnest thing to talk about, fixing roads and infrastructure, but they're all things that need to be done. And I think each of you that's been out there that's taken pictures of roads knows just how important that is. Just tonight in talking with some of my neighbors, how ice gathers up when there's no drainage and things like that. I think it's time that we start helping ourselves out. There's counties, all but three of us in the state. Fremont County is one of the three that doesn't have this tax. You look at a county like Natrona County that's had this tax for over 20 years, and the things that they've been able to do are absolutely amazing. I'm just floored every year, and obviously they're bigger than we are, but the amount of things that they're able to pay for with that tax just astound me, and we all pay that. Every time you go to Casper, you get to chip in on that. So I think it's time for us to return the favor, and when they come here, they can help us pay for our roads too. So thank you.
Thank you. I think the thing that just struck me when I got into this was the realization that on the 4 cents that we're collecting now on tax, when we go out to Walmart and buy something and spend a dollar in tax out there, we send that down to actually the businesses collect that for us and send it down to Cheyenne. I was admonished one time that it's not the city that collects it, it's the businesses that collects it, the citizens, and they send it down to Cheyenne and then it comes back. But for that dollar that we send down there, the state takes 70 cents just right off the top, okay? And then they send 30 cents back to the county, and the county distributes it back to the municipalities and across the county based on population. And so the city of Riverton gets about 26% of that 30 cents that's sent. So we actually realize about 8 cents out of every dollar in tax that we send to Cheyenne. Now on the 1%, we send a dollar down there, they take 1 cent off of the top for administrative charges and send 99 cents back. So we'll be getting several times more monies out of a dollar in tax on the 1% than we will in $4 in tax on the way it's taxed now. But so it's a huge difference for us, and it's, but when you stop and think about that, boy, it's, for me it's just a no-brainer. But it is a tax, and I know that we're, especially in these economic times, why things are hard, and if you're especially on a fixed income, why it's going to be a tough sell to get it passed. But as you've heard this evening, our community certainly needs it. When we've got roads that, you know, pure gas is in the terrible shape that it's in, didn't even make it in the top 10. That's amazing. But at any rate, does anyone else care to comment?
Your Honor.
Yes,
Councilman. I'll just add that, I think the last number that I heard was that 40% of the sales tax collected in Fremont County is paid by people that don't live in Fremont County. Mm-hmm. So that's a sizable portion of that, and then it's an interesting tax that we're not imposing, that somebody's not imposing on us. Okay. It's our choice to make whether or not we're going to get taxed, and so we elect that. I think that's a real fair way to pay for the services that that we expect to get out of the community.
I will mention also that Mayor Mick Wolf came over from Lander the other day, and then Scott Peters, the mayor from Shoshone, came over, and the three of us did a taping session here discussing these issues, and we've made a video copy of that, and I'm giving it to the news media as well as all of our FCAG representatives to get out in the community. So if you have an opportunity to listen to that, I'd really encourage you to, you know, to hear from other people besides just myself and whatnot. But, you know, the small communities are having a terrible time dealing with this problem as well. And you say, well, Shoshone's only going to get $114,000, it's estimated, out of this. But they can leverage that through a matching grant, okay, to get a lot more money. And according to Mayor Peters, why, that may not sound like a lot of money to Riverton, but let me tell you, it's a lot of money for Shoshone. And so I just think it's the right thing for us to do. So it's my understanding that we're going to be airing that video on Channel 11, and I haven't heard the specific dates, but it's about a half hour recording, and if you have the opportunity, I encourage you to listen to it. And if you have any questions, why, drop by the office. I'd enjoy visiting with you. Okay, with that, I would entertain a motion to adjourn the work session.
I move we adjourn.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.